Testies, testies, one. Right, I'll do this intro quickly. It's my birthday. We spent last night at Northern Monk headquarters celebrating with some of my nearest and dearest. And as a perfect hangover cure, the next day we've come out to Majorca to explore the Never Eat Shredded Wheat western side. And we're going to stick mainly to the coast and just see what the sea has to offer and the mountains, and then I'll just report back to you and see. If you like it, you like it. If you don't, you don't. I'm here with... cheers, look. Let's go. Hola, señor.
Señor Carballo. Hola. Buenos días. ¿Qué tal?
I think he might be German. Called Banyal Bufa. I'll put the name on the screen now, because just in case anyone's watching this and fancies a little jolly and you like what you see, I'll put the name of the little village. I am sponsored by the village as well, so anyone who comes here, I get one of them massive Toblerones at the airport as I leave, so you'll be doing me a favour. Oh, beautiful little, it's like a beautiful little vineyard. Medusa to the face. So I'm gonna dunk the junk and head out and show you what's underwater, see if you can see some marine life.
There's a lot of jellyfish, but I'm just weaving in and out of them, trying to stay away from the... It's the things that you can't see that'll get you. Whew. So you've got to just have your wits about you, and it's stunning. There's one just here.
Woo! I've swum right out here. Found a huge rock I'm standing on. It's got like a drop off the side of it, which I'm gonna go, it's quite deep, I'm gonna dive down.
What we need to do is...
I'm just giving it a little go on video blogging. Is that what you call it?
Yeah. Vlogging.
Exactly, vlogging. It's how I like day in Majorca, and we're driving to a place called Sawyer.
Sawyer Mini. That's just an in joke for lads. Carry on.
I don't know about that sort of, but there's been quite a lot of jellyfish, and what we learn is that they're called in groups swarms or blooms or smacks of jellyfish. So that's a little fact we picked up along the way. I was a bit too nervous to get in, and it got a bit choppy actually, so you couldn't see very well. Anyway, so today we're gonna go from the other direction from Sawyer maybe to Daya and go to the bits where we didn't see, and hopefully it, well, the sea looks less choppy, and we'll see. And we're just going on the long and winding roads. It doesn't actually look that bad here, but they've been really narrow, and there's these like little ledges at the side, so if your wheel comes off, you just go tumbling down.
Yeah, can I just interject?
Yep.
And say, alright lads, just say, if you are going to hire a car, you better have some serious stones, or if you're a woman,
stone.
Just still stones, because it's just not, it doesn't have to be technical, it can be anything, just means you've got to have nerves of steel, because it is very windy. But it's the first time.
And there's loads of cyclists.
Yeah.
But one little fact is the roads are really good quality.
Quality roads.
That's another good thing.
How many potholes have we seen this holiday?
Zero.
And we look for potholes, so.
That's what we judge our holidays on.
Hola. Testy, testy. Unos, dos. Unos, dos, tres. We're on a mission today to find a natural spa. So we're on this coast, and we're going to go and find, reportedly there's mud baths, so you can find this nutrient mineral rich red soil, and you lather it all over your body and your hair, you let it bake off in the sun and then wash it off in the sea, and it rejuvenates you and you look younger, and if you can imagine it, more attractive. Which I'm here with my co-host.
Hi.
Ali T. Hi. And yeah, it's maybe a few miles down this coastline, but it's beautiful, as you can see. So we'll show you some scenery on the way, we'll maybe take a few dips, I'll let you have a look under the water, with the result in us being caked in mud.
Yes, let's go.
What does it smell of?
Pine needles and sunshine.
Smells like pine needles and sunshine. There you go. There's no map to say where it is. It's just off a few, would you say, blogs or?
Forums.
Yeah, just off a few forums online have said remotely the area in which it is. So we're flying blind, and if we don't find it, sorry. If the thumbnail isn't of us blathered in red mud, you know we haven't found it. But we live in hope. What's that?
Time for the red bird bath.
Precarious. One false move and your fish food. I mean, there are worse coastlines to die in. At least they'll be able to find your body, because the visibility is spot on. What we got?
Pagan nests.
One, two, three, four. Pagan nests. What do you think, pagan? For what? For?
I don't know, celebrations.
Celebrations.
Maybe for spring. I don't know.
For the solstice, or for maybe laying pagan eggs. It is such a fun walk.
But not sarcastic.
Not even sarcastic. Sounds sarcastic, doesn't it? We're having a right fun old time, guys. We actually are. There's loads of different options in ways to go. You have to keep doubling back on yourself, because sometimes it's the wrong way. And it's like, turn to page 33 if you want to go. You know, all them old books that you used to read with multiple choices. Is this, what is this? What are you doing? Is that content?
Adam and Eve.
Would you Adam and Eve it? No, but that's actually the leaf of a fig tree. Got any figs? No fruit on it though. What did you say?
It's like the Mediterranean Blair Witch Project.
It's like the Mediterranean Blair Witch Project. You've heard it. That's that.
With all the...
Yeah.
It's not as scary.
Not as scary, is it? Sort of beautiful. But I know you're saying it's a derelict house.
With all the...
All the...
Wooden structures.
Yeah. Bits of it falling down there that we're just crossing.
And like a dungeon.
Like a dungeon. Because I don't know about you guys, but nothing says creepy more than carved love hearts. Where's she gone, look? Hey, aloe vera. For all you boffins. Couple of little figs on there, but they're not ripe, so we'll leave them to ripen up. This is the area. We've hiked it. We've been down to a few of the little bits and had a look around. Couldn't see. But Alice has spotted up in the distance some what looks like red mud.
And there was like water dripping down.
This might be it. It's whoa. It's actually this huge rock and someone's built in the side of it a door. Yeah. There it is. That must be it. There's like grass hanging down. Natural spring, it looks like it. So we're gonna have a look and then we can leave all our stuff down here. And this, someone's built this into the rock. And what I'm guessing is, many moons ago, this logs on each side would have acted as a to keep his boat stable. He pulled it up here, and if right at the top there's a tree at the top with a winch on it, and that's how he'd have got his boat in and out. One man and his boat. But it's since been left to rack and ruin. But we've spotted the mud over there. We've got our clobber on, or taken our clobber off, should I say. And let's... let's go see if this is rejuvenating and makes us any younger, because today is my birthday, so it's the there's no other place that I'd rather be than with Ali T covering myself in mud next to the sea.
Yeah, look, you see people digging out like little rabbits.
Oh yeah,
you see their fingerprints
there.
Yeah.
So that's where people have been digging out.
The natural stream must be running down.
Natural stream running down.
Yeah, like
right, this is it. He's going for it.
Yeah.
She's going for it. Get it on.
You want some?
Mission accomplished. I do want some, but I can't get it on my camera, on my hands. I'll have to go one-handed or something. Oh, shall I?
Do you want me to rub it on you?
Put the camera down. Right.
Get in.
Get in. Initial thoughts, cold.
Refreshing.
Refreshing. No messing. Straight for the face. All in hair. Because apparently, good for hair. I've gone deep. I've gone straight in. Oh, like that film, California Man. Cave paintings. Oh. Feel younger already. Have I got it on me?
So you've got ginger hair now.
Gingivitis.
Is that on me?
You've got a little bit on me, yeah. And this is where we find out that there's loads of people lapping up some luxurious mud in the thing next door, and this is all slurry from
hotel.
Come here. Ooh, there you go. I'm getting it right up in eyes. Like Rambo when he comes out at cliff. Remember that on Rambo? Should I do that bit? Seeing Rambo when he's just hiding at cliff like that. And he's got his eyes closed. Is it on my eyelids?
Yeah.
It's like that, and then he just goes.
Yeah, that's good actually.
And opens his eyes.
Also, your eyes match the green.
Boom. Like that. Jonathan Rambo. I've gone AWOL in it. I feel like I've got more than you. Right. Hopefully this is good for skin and it doesn't start burning her out. Makes your teeth look nice and white as well. Just look. There you go, look. I want some on my ear as well. John Rambo wouldn't miss ears out, would he? You've got your eyelids are white though. So man. Imagine if someone just comes along now. Your average Joe just comes along walking his dog. He wouldn't even see us for a start. And then we go, hiya mate. Hiya. Oh us, don't worry about us. This is content this, isn't it? It's good content or what? It's gotta be good content this, hasn't it? Ah, if you've
I was so excited about when I read about it.
Come here, it makes my hair look good. If you've tuned in to see wild camping or spearfishing or anything like that, this isn't for you, but...
This is the beauty.
This is it, nature. This is outdoors.
Health and beauty section.
Health and beauty section, now that...
No, that's sexist.
That's sexist, I didn't mean that. Because Joey, these also into air and beauty. So, come on. Oh, it's starting to dry on me already.
We need to bake ourselves now.
Oh yeah, we need to bake ourselves at... 180 degrees, gas mark 6 for around 30 to 35 minutes. You just look like the naughty kid at school who's been let loose with the pens. I look like a caveman. No, I look like John Rambo, who am I kidding? Look at you. Hey yo, Mrs. Rambo. Joanne Rambo. It's a wonderful excuse just to go and blather you selling red mud by the coast, whether it has benefits or not. Right, so it does actually have some benefits, I've found out for you. Just a little tidbit. Both clay and mud are natural substances rich in minerals. I'm not reading this. This is just off the... It's what I've learnt, you see. And the powerful effects on the body and skin... Besides serving as an effective relaxing therapy, they regenerate our skin, leaving it smooth and moisturised. They also have anti-inflammatory effects, help the body's production of collagen, and release muscle strain and help eliminate toxins. So, it's a tick. It's a tick for the mud. Let's get back to John Rambo.
We go in the salty sea.
We're not going to call it getting baked, are we?
Getting baked in Majorca.
Getting baked in Majorca, she's saying. Caught you. Are you getting in now?
No, I need to get baked.
You need to get baked first. It's been about 35 minutes. This stuff's dried on now. Totally baked on. It doesn't feel too bad. It feels quite nice. So, I'm going to switch to the GoPro. And then get out in the sea. There we are. Right, let's go and get in the juice. We were caked in the mud, and then we've washed it off and dipped in and out. Smooth skin, it's like we've been to a spa. There's dogs down there, there's nudists everywhere, so I can't really film too much. And that's why I didn't do too much filming today, because when in Rome, or when in on a nudist section, you just got to get into it, haven't you?
Nudista.
Nudista. Ah, and the sun's going down. What a beautiful day, and a great way to spend a birthday. We're going to hike out of here now, but I can't even put a link to it. You'll just have to get on forums if you want to find the magical elixir of youth mud fountain. You'll have to get on forums and have a look for it. We've had a word, we both feel at least 3 weeks younger.
Smoother.
Smoother. A lot smoother as well. So as the sun sets on the last night on this beautiful island, I'll bid you adios.
Hasta luego.
And there you go, just that.
And that's holidays.
Again, and that's holidays. see ya. Thanks for tuning in. Banter. Banterous. Alright, let's pack this up and let's get out of here. I'm like Jordan, trying to rise onto the top. Me, I'm trying to be an icon from the jump. They were war, then I let bygones be bygones. Cause they bars all have gone by the month. Me, I'm trying to be an icon from the jump. They were war, then I let bygones be bygones. Cause they bars all have gone by the month.